and gentlemen, welcome to Game 2 of Hayes High and Garden City. Now it's time for the boys to try to beat Garden City. The Hayes High boys are coming into this contest at a 17-0, the best start in school history, as the Garden City Buffaloes come in at 11-7. Here in moments, we'll throw it down to Dan Bowman for the national anthem. I'm Casey Wise. I'll be joined alongside Brandon Wise here for the call of Game 2.
About to catch a great basketball game this evening between the Hayes High Indians and the Garden City Buffalo. Here in about 5 seconds, we're going to kick it down to public address announcer Dan Bowman for the starting lineups.
Welcome to Hayes High School in this Western Athletic Conference game between the Buffaloes from Garden City and your Hayes High Indians. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet tonight's starting lineups for Garden City. A 6'5" junior number 0, Caleb Tramp. And for the Indians, a 5'10" senior number 3, Connor Nirenberger. And for the Buffaloes, a 5'10" sophomore number 3, Jared Custer. And for the Orange Indians, a 6-foot senior number 14, Jordan Reynolds. And for the Buffaloes, a 5'9" senior number 5, Mitchell Hernandez. And for your Indians, a 6-foot senior number 20, Clark. And for the Buffalo, a 6'1" senior number 10, Tristan Neninga. And for your Indians, a 6'7" junior number 25, Bruno Worth. And for the Buffalo, a 6'5" junior number 13, Luis Rodriguez. And for your Indians, a 6'2" senior number 33, Kate Parker. Head coach of the Buffalo, J.C. Holloway. And head coach of the Indians, Rick Keltner. His assistants, Mark Watts, Tim Munry, and Fred Wetter. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please rise? As members of the Hayes High Drumline, Andrew McGinnis, Mikey Prouts, Grace Walker, Tristan Callis, Austin Pitts, and Sam Crowley honor our great nation with the playing of our national anthem.
One player to highlight tonight for the Buffaloes is number 0, Caleb Tramp. The kid is a premier scorer, and when it comes down to crunch time, he's the one that's going to step up. And then for the Indians, the player to watch is number 20, Lane Clark. The kid is a machine. He's going to be all over the floor on offense, knocking down threes, all over people on defense. He's the he's the person to watch for the Hayes High Indians.
Hayes High loaded with senior starters, too. Four of the starters for Hayes High are seniors. Hayes High has six starters that are seniors total this year, a very experienced team. Brady Worth, the only junior starting for Hayes High. Also another player to watch tonight.
The coaches this evening are for the Hayes High Indians, Rick Keltner, and for the Garden City Buffaloes, it is J.C. Holloway. Worth and Tramp will be part of the tip-off this evening, and we're underway.
Tip goes advantage Hayes High. Kyler Nurnberger will bring it down the court now for the Indians. Worth the Winholes. Winholes back to Nurnberger. Great ball movement here early by the Hayes High Indians. Cade Parker now up top, back to Nurnberger. Nurnberger averaging 7.6 assists per game. Now Winholes for three, and he drains it.
Winholes is a big player for this team. He's the second player that you got to watch. He can create his own shot whenever he wants. He's a primary scorer for this team.
And now you'll see here Hayes High student section getting into it. 13 rows filled full of Hayes High students. As Garden City with an early turnover.
Coin themselves the Wall of Boom. You got to watch out. These guys will get into the game.
Last week was a quiet game for the Wall of Boom and still hit 102 decibels. Kyler Nurnberger will bring the ball up the court now for the Indians.
This place is packed tonight. People know it's about to be a great game. Number three in 5A, Hayes High taking on Garden City. It's going to be a wild one.
A WAC conference game. Brady Worth now inside for two.
Nice feed there by Kyler Nurnberger. That's his thing, assists. He's going to be passing the ball all over the floor.
Garden City now bringing the ball up. Coster looks like the point guard for Garden City tonight.
Indians running a little bit different defense than they typically do. Clark, instead of being in the middle of the top, it's Nurnberger. A nice move there by the Buffalo player.
Kyler
Tramp.
Nurnberger being sloppy with it, and Tramp steals away. Kyler gets the rebound, though.
Now, that is something you won't see from Tramp a lot. Two easy misses right by the hoop.
Lane Clark thought about it from the wing, but drives inside. Now kicks it out to Winholes. Winholes loses it, but regains possession. Now back out to Parker.
Indians need to settle down here a little bit. They're looking good, but they need to just chill.
Parker out to Lane. Clark for three. No good. The first miss for the Indians of this game.
Clark's a machine from outside the arc. That's a miss you're not going to see very often.
Foul called on the play. It'll remain Indians ball.
Looked to be a reach on the Buffaloes. Good job by Cade Parker to be strong with the basketball.
Kyler Nurnberger will bring it up for the Indians. Foul looks to be called on zero of Caleb Tramp.
Tramp needs to stay out of foul trouble. When their first meeting in the Hayes City shootout, that was pretty much the highlight of his day, was being in foul trouble the majority of the evening.
Kate Parker looking inside for Brady Worth, but that pass is a little bit outside. Turnover on Hayes High.
Questionable pass considering Worth had two defenders on him. You like to feed him down low, but sometimes you gotta hold yourself back.
Hayes High not averaging many turnovers per game, just right around the 10 turnover mark.
Pretty typical for a high school basketball team, and you gotta expect them to be really efficient. Once again, that Hayes High student section getting into it here. That'll really affect you more than you'd ever think.
Turnover! Jordan nice. Winholes with the steal.
Nice heads-up play there by Winholes.
Winholes out to Parker. Parker to Nurnberger. Nurnberger to Clark on the wing. That shot is blocked.
And that's a great ball movement there by the Indians, although the shot was blocked.
Foul called that time on number three, Kyler Nurnberger. Nurnberger's first foul of the game. Or actually, Jordan Winholes will be getting the foul. First team foul for the Indians.
And I like the defense by Winholes. Although he did get the foul, that's a good play. He tried to knock the ball out, and it was a really good move there by the Buffalo player.
Daniga at the line for Garden City. Garden City. He misses the first.
The Indians, their offense feeds off of stealing the ball and getting into the break quick. That's where they get a majority of their points. It's been working very well this season.
Nanninga one for two at the line. Now Nurnberger will bring it up.
Hayes High with only a two-point lead here early in this contest. Inside to Nurnberger. Nurnberger back out to Parker. Parker to Clark. Clark thought about it but went back out to Nurnberger.
This is a team that's going to live and die by the three. All season they've been living by it, and let's hope tonight isn't the night where they die.
Still have a lot of points in the paint with Brady Worth, a big man. Tramp, though, equally as large, but Brady Worth with a good look there.
Yeah, that was good defense by Tramp. Although he let him slip around, he put enough pressure on Worth that Worth rushed the shot. A wild take there by the Buffaloes. And Tramp finishes inside, as we would expect him to do quite a bit tonight.
So at the 4:12 mark, it's tied 5-5. Winholz thought about it, now drives inside. Got off balance and put up a questionable shot. Now he steals the ball back. Now he goes up. Hayes High missing early on those easy twos.
Winholz needs to take a breath. I like his aggression, but he's just a little out of control. He needs to be aggressive, but he needs to slow himself down a little bit.
Coster bringing up the ball for the Buffaloes. Picks up the dribble.
The Indians playing very good defense right now, but thing with Garden City, they have no one moving off ball. Everybody's standing still. You can't get good looks that way, and especially how slow they're swinging it.
Hayes High typically starts off strong in the first quarter, outscoring opponents by nearly 7 points on average in the first quarter.
Yeah, it's pretty close right now, 5-5 with over half of the quarter gone. That's not typical for this team.
Hayes High averaging about 16 points in the first quarter. Timeout taken that time by Garden City.
And something abnormal that I've seen is Lane Clark's taken two shots so far, missing the first and the second being blocked. That's not typical for him. He doesn't like to force a lot of them. He waits till he gets his open ones, and then he knocks them down.
Garden City taking a 30-second timeout at the 3:17 mark here in the first quarter.
Yeah, with the two matchups in this game, you got to look at there's two headlines from the two games. The first one, Hayes High beating Garden City for the Hayes City Shootout Championship. The second one is, this may be not known by a lot of people, but it kind of went around, was the big alley-oop dunk that Brady Worth had in Garden City. That was a big win for them in Garden City's house.
Again, this is a WAC conference game. Hayes High again, 17-0 on the season.
Man, Garden City needs to step up to the arc, and they need to try running some stuff off ball, because swinging it that far outside the arc is not going to get them anything. That's a good pick there. That's going to help a little bit.
Tramp inside. Riedel on the defense, and Tramp gets it to fall.
It's a good look by Tramp. Tramp is a efficient scorer down low. Definitely a focal point of their offense.
Clark now with the ball, looking inside. Nothing there. He kicks it out to the wing.
Isaiah Nunnery, he is definitely the sixth man of this offense. The kid can score at will.
Coster now with the ball for the Buffaloes. Lane Clark on defense now will kick it out to Delgado. Delgado tries to pass it out, but Nunnery tips it. Coster comes back up with it. Now Delgado back inside. Garden City with a good look. Now Coster back with the ball with a layup, and that'll fall.
Yeah, that was a nice move there by Coster. That's what you want to see from a guard.
Now Garden City takes the lead at 9-8. Clark inside, kicks it out to Winholz. Winholz for three, and he'll nail it.
This team lives with the three. Everybody on that team except for, well, Brady Worth, he can knock them down sometimes too. They all like to shoot the three, and they can all definitely make it.
Coster bringing up the ball again. Nunnery with great defense outside.
Nunnery's coming out with some high intensity right now. I'm really liking what he's putting out there. He's being a true sixth man to his team right now.
Garden City's playing the ball about 15 feet outside the arc.
They need to step closer to the arc. They're getting no looks out there.
Now they go to penetrate. Clayton Riedel on the inside, but that one will fall.
That was a very, very nice take.
We're all knotted up at 11 with 1 minute left here in the first quarter. Clark inside to Riedel, and Riedel knocks down the two.
Riedel, a student that moved from a different school, came in here, and he is a big part of this offense. Another great scorer off the bench, someone who can come in and fill the gaps that typically you would lose from someone like Brady Worth sitting on the bench.
Nunnery, some great defense again on Coster. Delgado now with the ball. Out to Nininga.
Yeah, I don't. The
Garden City looks to be trying to hold it for maybe the final shot. Back to Koster. Winholds now on the defense. Now Nunry. Delgado out to Koster. Koster drives inside. Clayton Real got a hand on it, but that one will fall.
That was a good decision. They were running the clock down, but he got too good of a look to pass up. That was a smart play by the Buffalo player.
Now Hayes High will look to take the final shot of the first quarter. Game tied at 13. 6 seconds left on the clock. Nunnery driving inside now. He'll take a good look, and that one will fall as time expires in the first quarter.
It was a nice take there by Nunnery. And we will be right back for the second quarter of action.
The second quarter of play. Hayes High with the advantage, 15-13 over Garden City.
Garden City needs to step into the arc right here. Yes, they've scored, but they could score a lot better if they would step in and not let Hayes High push them back.
Third pass that time gets intercepted by Kyler Nurnberger.
Man, Nurnberger should have just tried to take it farther down the floor. I know he's not a scorer. He's
Nurnberger into Worth for the easy basket.
Yeah, I told right there, he's a passer, but I mean, This offense lives on the break. I would have liked to see him push that one a little bit more.
So Hayes High with a good start to the second quarter. Naninga with the ball now for Garden City.
Garden City's getting that quick off-ball movement. That's what they needed to start doing.
Naninga for two now. Nurnberger will bring it up. Nurnberger looking to Winholz. Winholz now trying to get it inside to Brady Worth. Brady Worth with the and one.
That's what he does. He goes in, draws contact, gets fouled, or he finishes. He's their leading scorer on this team.
Brady Worth averaging 15 points a game this season. Next closest to him is Jordan Winholz, averaging 13 points per game.
Worth is a junior, is close to averaging a double-double. I believe he averages close to 9 rebounds a game.
And Worth will complete the three-point play.
Hayes High will be taking a 30-second timeout here.
Good start to the second quarter for the Indians.
This is just the game I expected. I expected it to be a dogfight. I know Garden City isn't ranked in 5A, but they are still a very good basketball team. Hayes High ranked 3rd in the state, and they're good. We'd like to remind everybody that we are on channel 13 on Eagle and channel 167 on Nextech, and you can also go online to HayesHighIndians.com, and there should be a banner that you can click on and view this on your computer.
Hayes High looking to continue what they've started here in the second quarter of play. Hayes High not averaging as much in the middle two quarters as they do in the final two. Only about 14 points averaged in the second quarter.
Looks like the Indians are going to put on somewhat of a 3/4 court press. I kind of like it. I like to see that press, especially when they like to steal the ball and push the break. It's exactly what they need to be doing.
Naninga operating point for Garden City. Now to Delgado. Back to Naninga. Kyler Nurnberger on the defense. Naninga thought about it. Now back to Delgado. Delgado for three. And that one will not go in. Brady Worth with the rebound.
It's going to be interesting to see who's going to be the primary scorer right now for Garden City with Tramp sitting on the bench.
Henry with the ball inside to Worth. Worth getting double teamed, and now the foul.
And right there, Worth, when he gets the ball in the post, he's got to do something with it quick, because as soon as he catches it, there's going to be another guy coming, because he can score. He's a very proficient scorer down there in the paint.
Nürnberger with the inbound now. Watch for the alley-oop pass. Brady Worth was not ready for it, but back out to Nunnery. Back inside to Brady Worth. Foul called that time on number 32, Luis Garala.
Haven't been a whole lot of fouls in this game so far. It's been pretty clean. Hopefully it stays that way. It's always fun to watch some clean basketball.
That's his second foul of the game and fourth team foul for Garden City. Tramp back in the game for Garden City now.
Something you don't see often, Worth inbounding.
Worth going inside. Layup not falling. Now Riedel with the rebound. Worth getting blocked, and it was a foul.
This is something we don't see very often from the Indians, having two centers in the game at the same time. Riedel and Worth, you don't see them on the floor at the same time very often. Looks like they may be trying a different type of offense, and right there getting multiple rebounds in a row.
Looks like they called that foul on number zero, Caleb Tramp. That'll be his second foul of the game, so already at the six-minute mark in foul trouble early.
Yeah, he just came back into the game and picks up his second foul. He can't let it get like last game. See, right there, he's going to have to go back to the bench because he's got two. Same thing happened when they played here in the Hayes City shootout. Tramp got in early foul trouble, and he couldn't be in the game to keep his team close so that they were there in the end.
Worth made the first, and now will make the second.
Worth is a very good free throw shooter for a big man. He knocks down a good majority of his free throws, something you like to see.
Brady Worth at 64.5% on the season from the free throw line. Costa with the ball, now to Delgado. Delgado drives, kicks it out. Back out to Costa.
Man, I like the aggression of the Garden City offense right there. I think if they would have had one more person slide around and drive, they would have gotten a very good look.
Aired pass almost gets away from Costa, but he will regain it. And now the student section comes alive as Nunnery steals it. Now Nürnberger driving to the rim, and he will get fouled hard.
That was a nice take by Nürnberger. Great play by Nunnery. Nunnery, I'm telling you, he is the sixth man of this team. Played varsity his freshman year. Played very well, and he's back again this year, and now he's in a bigger role. Gets more playing time than he did last year, and he's a big part of this team. Always gives them the lift they need.
Foul was called on the floor, so now Hayes High will throw it in. Nürnberger back to the throwing it in. Watch out for Worth. He gets it to Parker. Parker goes up for the layup, but no good. Now on the second chance, he will miss as well. Now the long rebound gets collected by Winholtz. Winholtz gets it to Worth. Now Nürnberger's ball.
Surprised Clark passed that one up. I think he's a little concerned after that first miss and that block. Needs to get his confidence back. He's a big shooter for this team. Hit many big shots in his career.
Nürnberger with the ball now. Nürnberger driving inside. He'll pull it back out to Winholtz. Winholtz fakes it and tries to go inside, but that one gets broken up. And now Garden City will turn it over.
Yeah, Winholtz wanted to take it inside, and when he jumped, there were two people in front of him, one person behind him. A little concerned with the people in front of him. The person behind tipped the ball.
So Garden City will maintain possession. Now Coster will bring it up for Garden City. Now to number five, Hernandez. Delgado driving inside. Good pass.
That's a great pass right there. That's what they need to do. They need a drive and dish, and that's exactly what he needed to do in that situation.
Rodriguez with the good finish. Now Nürnberger with the ball to Parker. Parker looking to Clark. Clark with the open three.
Yeah, it was a little bit deep, but I still have a feeling he's lost a little bit of confidence that he needs to get back here pretty quick.
Another good look for Clark, and now he gets another shot blocked.
And Clark needs to pick it up here. If he's cold, this team, somebody else is going to have to step up.
Clark very tentative with the ball here early. Delgado with the ball now. Now back out to Coster. Coster to Hernandez. Hernandez with the shot, and that one will fall.
Nice shot there. Very, very under control. A good little jumper.
Winholtz goes up for it and looked to be fouled, but no call. Now Brady Worth with the putback.
That's what that team does. They made the shot, and they still pushed it down the floor, still got a bucket. Got to be on your toes with this team.
Koster bringing it down for Garden City. He'll drive inside. Big man Brady Worth almost got a piece of it. Now Kyler Nurnberger coming down with the rebound. He'll push it up the floor. Nurnberger now to Parker. Parker signaling Nurnberger to come back up. Nurnberger now with the ball. Back to Parker. Parker looking now back to Nurnberger. Nurnberger inside to Worth. Worth fumbles it. Fight for it on the floor. Jump ball.
Good hustle play there by Worth. He didn't give up on it. Got down there. Got the jump ball. And with possession arrow, Indians will keep it. Back to Clark's shooting struggles. He's a four-sport varsity athlete. The kid is used to pressure. I do not think the slump's going to last long. He's going to pull himself out of it. He definitely knows what he's doing out there.
Hayes High maintaining a five-point lead with 3:14 left. Worth with the shot, and now looks like an offensive foul. Fouls on number 33, Cade Parker. That'll be his first personal and the second team foul.
The Indians haven't been going to their bench very much here early. That's a little abnormal. Usually at home they do a lot of substitutions, but they've kept their starters in a good majority of this game.
Normally you see Hayes High go to the bench more so early. Leninga with the ball, now back to Koster. Koster to Hernandez. Hernandez looking, back to Koster.
Looks like there was a push inside. It's going to be on number 33, Cade Parker. Now he all of a sudden has two fouls in a matter of about 30 seconds.
Parker not liking that call, but now Clayton Riedel will come in for him.
You got to be smart out there. Your coach is looking for you to play a lot of minutes. You can't pick up silly fouls to get pulled out of the game.
Hernandez into Leninga. Koster now with the ball. Looking for Hernandez. Now we'll get it to him. But again, Garden City way outside the arc here early on offense. Now Nurnberger comes up. Leninga with the ball now. Again, Hayes High running 3-2 zone here early.
Yeah, once again, they have those two big men in, something that they've just started doing recently because of Parker's foul
Hernandez
trouble.
Hernandez drives it inside, and Clark gets a piece of it. Brady Worth comes up with the ball, and now Nurnberger's bringing it up the court.
Nurnberger, nice
Nurnberger
take.
Driving it inside. Clayton Riedel was who he's looking for, and Riedel can't finish.
Man, that's Nurnberger can find open men. He's just, it's an art, and he's figured it out.
Again, Nurnberger averaging 7.6 assists per game. Could have had another one there, but Riedel unable to finish. Now Leninga with the ball for Garden City. Out to Hernandez. Hernandez back to Leninga. That one was tipped by Nunnery, but he's the last one to touch it, so Garden City will maintain possession.
Good hustle play there by Nunnery. Couldn't quite save the ball, but still it's a great play.
1:48 left to play here in the first half. Leninga with the ball out to Koster. Both teams have really only played their starting five and only dipped one or two players into their bench so far.
Garden City's offense is struggling right now with Tramp on the bench with two early fouls. He definitely needs to get himself out of foul trouble in this game so that if Garden City wants any opportunity of winning this one.
Leninga with the ball. Now he will wave Koster off, keep it himself. Now he'll drive inside, kicks it out to Koster. Koster picked up by Riedel and Worth. Ball's tipped around, but Garden City will maintain possession. Now Koster looking to get it back outside. Shot was a little off. Now Nunnery will bring it up for the Indians. Nunnery looking for Nurnberger. Gets it to him now. Riedel with the ball. Back to Nurnberger. Nurnberger inside to Worth. Worth with the easy bucket.
Nice pass there by Nurnberger. Found the open man. Worth finished it.
So now Hayes High stretches the lead out to 7. With a mere 45 seconds left here in the first half. Koster bringing it up for the Buffaloes. Hernandez with the ball now. He'll drive inside. Foul on the floor.
It's going to be a reach. I think it's going to be on.
Foul's on number 3, Kyler Nurnberger. That's his first, only the fourth team foul here in the first half. Leninga with the shot, and that one will fall. Riedel now inbounds it to Nunnery. Nunnery pushing the pace with 30 seconds left here in the first half. Hayes High will probably try to wait for the last shot here.
Been a very fast half, very few fouls. Makes things go quickly.
It's It's always what you like to see is a clean basketball game. Only 10 fouls total for both teams here in the first half. Clark with the ball. Clark going to his right, now back out to Nunnery. Nunnery to Nurnberger. 7 seconds left on the clock. Nurnberger looking. Nurnberger gets that one tipped. 1.7 left to play here in the first half. Nurnberger losing it there. Hayes High maintains possession to Nurnberger. Nurnberger shoots the three, and that will not fall. So going into halftime, the scores, Hayes High 26, Garden City 21.
Yeah, it was a quick half for the Indians. Didn't put up quite the points they normally had. Clark was silent, but still a good half for the Indians. And we are going to have a quick interview with head coach Rick Keltner with Landon Munch right now.
Let's get off the court anyway.
All right. Okay. Coach Keltner, I'm here. What are your thoughts on the first half? We had a huge lift from Brady Worth. It was pretty tight. What are your thoughts?
We got to quit throwing the ball away and do a better job at guarding dribble penetration. We're letting them come right down the lane and shoot. So okay. We got to get better.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you, Landon, and we will be right back.
You spent yourself on a faraway love. It was bad for the heart, but good for the soul.
like to sleep all day and party all night. This is how we like to live our life.
Hands up!
USD 49 Media, connecting the community to education.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Hayes High School. It's halftime of the varsity boys basketball game. Score is 26-21. the number three ranked 5A team, Hayes High, on top. We had a great first half of basketball so far. The Indians playing very well. Probably the highlight of their offense so far is the lack of production from senior Lane Clark. He's been struggling so far. He's been blocked twice, missed a three. He's struggling and needs to get going if this team wants to pull out in this game. And then if you look at the other –
you could really see that first half, those first couple shots, Lane had a confidence to him. And he was pulling the trigger right away. He got a couple misses and a couple blocks, and all of a sudden he started hesitating. He'd take that stutter. That's never something you want to see out of a player, is that little bit of a hesitation, because then gets off in their form and everything else. So Lane Clark really needs to get involved in this offense in the second half.
Brady Wirth, though, he's been playing very well for the Indians. He's been producing a little bit above his average for a first half. He's usually more of a second half presence. But, hey, that's not a bad thing when you got another player down.
Hayes High starters probably also wanting just a little bit of a break, as they've seen a majority of the playing time. Hayes High's bench has only dipped into Clayton Riedel and Isaiah Nunnery so far in the first half. No one else really getting any playing time, but Garden City in the same boat.
And then on the other side, Garden City, they've been playing a good ball game, and they're definitely still in this one. The highlight for them is Caleb Tramp, early foul trouble. The kids, he's going to have to stop fouling. He needs to get back in this ball game because he is his team's source of offense. He wins them ball games with his effectiveness on the inside. And so he needs to get out there. He needs to stay clean, and he needs to slow Brady Wirth down without fouling and getting more fouls, because he needs to stay in this ball game.
But now if you look on it from the other side, from Hayes High's side, what they want to do is go right at Caleb Tramp, keep him in foul trouble, and keep his minutes down as much as possible here in the second half. They did a good job. He probably didn't even play a total of 8 minutes in the first half due to foul trouble.
Yeah, they need to do what they did in the second quarter. He checked in for the first time in the second quarter, was in the game for 30 seconds, and Wirth took it right into him and got him his second foul, which made the coach pull him out right away and sit him on the bench.
Now we talk about the lack of presence from Lane Clark in the first half. Now Lane is actually only the third leading scorer on this Hayes High team. Jordan Winholtz and Brady Wirth are actually the two leading, with Wirth being the overall leader at 15.3 points per game. Winholtz really stepping up and filling the void left by Clark so far. Clayton Riedel doing a good job also, having to go in for Cade Parker in a couple instances. But overall, a good first half from the Hayes High Indians on both offense and defense.
Yeah, part of Clark, though, is once he gets going, he pulls defenders off. He gives space, and when he lacks that confidence and doesn't step up in there with confidence and knock down shots, that pulls away from the other players. If he knocks down one early, he's going to be fine. But he needs to find a bucket quick so he can get himself back into this ball game.
Now, you heard in the halftime interview, courtesy of Landon Munch, Coach Keltner say that Hayes High has been turning over the ball a lot here in the first half. Now, on the season, they only average about 10 turnovers per game. They had almost that in the first half. A lot of sloppy plays and not great quality passes from the Indians in the first half. See how they can adjust on that here to start this second half of action.
All right, and then I'm looking down on the court right now, and I'm seeing Lane Clark's getting a quick little talk with Rick Keltner. Maybe he's going to get him a little fired up and get him back into this ball game. And we will be going to break right now.
We'll always want you.
are back with our live coverage of Hayes High taking on Garden City. Getting ready to start the seventh half of action. The game is available on Eagle Channel 13, Next Tech Channel 167, and on the internet at HayesHighIndians.com. The Indians will start the third quarter with a 5-point lead over Garden City after one half of play. Hayes High looking for a quick start here in the third quarter to stretch out this lead. Hayes High ranked third in the state. They have spent some time at number one, though, this season, but falling down in the rankings due to a lack of games over the last couple weeks.
Lane Clark coming out with some intensity on defense. It's what you like to see from a player whose offense isn't quite working.
Koster with the travels, now Hayes High ball.
Koster got a little excited there. He saw it was open, wanted to shoot that three, bring this margin down to two, and just stepped into it.
Kyler Nurnberger will bring it up now for the Indians. Nurnberger to Clark. Clark looks for Parker, but takes a second look. Now back out to Nurnberger. Nurnberger to Parker. Parker back to Nurnberger. Now to Wendholz. Wendholz thinking about it. Now back out to Parker. Hayes High needing to get some penetration here. Nurnberger driving in. Back out to Wendholz. Wendholz for three. And that one is short. Now the long rebound Nurnberger will get. Nurnberger pushing it. Parker now with the three, and he'll nail that one.
Nurnberger is all over the floor right now. He is running the offense. He is being a true point guard right now.
Parker, not a guy you want to leave out wide open beyond the arc. Down to Ningo with the ball for Garden City.
Parker's the Ray Allen of this team. He likes to sit in the corner. He likes to shoot that corner three all day.
Good defense so far. Now Parker coming up with the steal.
So what the Indians need to do, they need to limit possessions of Tramp in the low post.
Nurnberger into Worth. Worth fumbling it now. Back out to Wendholz. Wendholz with the contested three. Just a little strong.
He shot with confidence. I like the confidence he had. He didn't hesitate. He thought he could make it. Definitely what you want to see in that kind of a situation.
Koster and Nininga out now, back to Koster. Koster setting up the Garden City offense.
Buffalo still sitting back off that three-point arc. They need to get moving off ball again.
And the student section of Hayes High comes alive as Nininga drains the shot for two.
Call themselves the Wall of Boom. They need to bring the boom right now.
Nurnberger bringing it up, back to Clark. Clark again quiet in the first half. Clark drives it in, now dishes it out to Brady Worth. Worth driving inside. Worth with two.
Nice take there by Worth. He had a bit of a mismatch. Tramp wasn't guarding him that time. Good job of taking it to the rim.
Koster bringing it up again for Garden City. Again, all the starters for both teams getting a lot of minutes in the first half, excluding Tramp for Garden City due to fouls.
Yeah, they need to move off ball. I don't know why they're not doing it. That's what they were doing at the end of the first half. That's what they need to get back to.
Garden City getting no penetration so far in this game. Now Tramp with the ball. Tramp throws it out to Hernandez. Hernandez for three, and he'll drain that one.
Hernandez just saved Tramp. Tramp was caught baseline, needed to dish it out, and just kind of threw it, and he went and got it.
Good ball movement there by the Indians. Clark looking for it now. Back out to Nurnberger. Nurnberger will set up the play now to Clark. Pass was a little wide to Clark. Clark thought about taking it, but there's the lack of confidence we talked about. Now Nurnberger with the ball.
Oh, they needed to swing it. If he would have swung it, it would have been right into Clark. Clark could have maybe gotten his confidence back.
Great backdoor cut by Parker there with the assist going to Nurnberger.
Nurnberger he's up there in the assist total right now. He's working his magic like he always does.
Koster with the ball. Now to Nininga at the top. Nininga looks about driving it, pulls up for a long two, and that one won't fall. Brady Worth with the rebound. Nurnberger bringing it up now for the Indians, out to Wendholz. Wendholz to Parker. Parker wide open, but too far out. Now back to Nurnberger. Nurnberger with the pass to Parker. Parker with the pass to Clark. Clark shoots it for three, and his drought continues. Tramp with the rebound inside.
He kind of forced that one a little bit. That wasn't a Lane Clark jump shot. He rushed that one out.
Koster for two, and that one will fall. With a Garden City player hitting hard, that was Nininga.
Garden City staying in this ball game. Nice take there by Wendholz. Very, very good job of getting the free throw line.
Wendholz fouled by number 15 of Garden City. That's Luis Rodriguez.
This is very atypical of the Indians at home. Most of the time at home, by the third quarter, they've got themselves a bit of a margin. They've got a comfort zone to them. And right now, with only a three-point lead, that's a little abnormal. I would like to say that this student section, the Wall of Boom, as they call themselves, have not been there to their normal amount. They need to get themselves in this game and fluster Garden City a little bit.
Wynhold's missing the first, now for the second. And he'll miss both. Very unusual for Wynhold's.
Yeah, typically he's a very good free throw shooter. That's very abnormal.
Wynhold's 60% on the season at the free throw line.
Man, he's thinking about shooting that one.
Hernandez pulls up for two, and Clark will get the rebound. Now Lane Clark pushing it down the floor.
Very nice dribbling there by Clark.
Nuremberger now with the ball. Nuremberger to Clark. Clark into Worth. Worth with the bucket down. They'll get blocked by the board, and there's a push.
Interesting play there. I would have liked to see a foul called on the initial shot by Brady Worth. It seemed like it was a foul. I'm all right with the no call, though. It did seem like Trent may have been straight up.
Delgado called for the foul. He didn't like it, but
getting a little physical right now. What you expect in a close ball game like this one.
Nuremberger inbounding. He gets it into Clark. Clark back to Nuremberger. Nuremberger drives inside. He'll put it back out to Wynhold's. Wynhold's now driving inside. Wynhold's with the floater. That one will get tipped up in the air. Parker trying to get it back out. And it'll stay possession Hayes High.
Man, there's a lot of people here tonight. This crowd could really get into it. I'm surprised they're not right now.
Packed to the rafters here today. Clark now to Nuremberger. Nuremberger looking to set something up. Now to Parker. Back to Nuremberger. Nuremberger trying to get it inside to Worth. Worth and Tramp very equal in size, which is something Worth hasn't had to deal with this season. He normally outshines everybody, but that pass is intercepted by Nininga. Wynhold's with the defense, but not good enough. Parker now pushing it down floor to Parker, and Brady Worth not looking back.
Lane Clark does not have his A game on right now. He needs to settle himself down, and he needs to get in this ball game right now. If Garden City gets out in front and starts pulling away, it's because Clark didn't get going. He's got to get himself in this ball game.
Worth did not look back on that pass. The pass was right there for him, but he was not expecting Hayes High to push the tempo as much as they did. Parker with a great inbound finding Clark. Would have been interesting to see what Worth would have been able to do with that ball had he gotten it. Now Nininga bringing it up for Garden City. Garden City closed within three now.
It's a one-possession ball game. A three-pointer right here would tie this game up.
Delgado now with the ball. He goes from the top of the key. Now dishes it back to Nininga. And the Wall of Boom comes alive.
Yeah, they need to bring it right now. This is when their team needs them.
Delgado for three. And he'll miss that one, but Tramp with the rebound. The long rebound. Quayton Rio had position, but Garden City got the good bounce.
Tramp was being physical. He wanted it more.
Nininga operating the offense for Garden City. Now inside.
Oh, nice pass right there. That was a great find.
Emilio Parr for two that time for Garden City. Garden City operating a bit of a press defense now. Nunnery bringing up the ball.
Someone from Hayes High needs to step up right now. Clark's not there. Someone needs to bring a presence to this team.
Clark thought about it, but pulls it back down. Now he drives inside, dishes it out to Nunnery. Nunnery for three, and that one won't find its way, but Parker with the rebound. Parker puts it up. Good defense that time by Tramp.
Tramp's a presence down low. It's not going to be easy to take it into him. Brady Worth's the only one that matches up to him well in size. Clayton Riedel does as well. But Parker definitely a bit of a mismatch trying to take it into Tramp.
1 point the difference here in the third quarter with only a minute left as Garden City takes a timeout.
Man, this game is flying. Very few fouls. We're already under a minute in the third quarter. It's a one-point ball game, and still, Clark is struggling. If he continues this into the fourth quarter, it's going to be interesting to see if Hayes High can pull this out. Clark is just such a big factor of this offense in ways that beyond scoring, beyond rebounds and all that. He pulls defenders off, and it's just how he plays. And he has to get himself into this game.
Garden City taking a full timeout there, so they have three left going into the – here towards the end of the third quarter. Hayes High still with four left. Garden City's taking a full and a 30-second timeout. Hayes High only taking a 30-second timeout. Hayes High still hanging on to a one-point lead.
Hayes High needs to get a stop right here. They need to keep this lead, and they definitely need the wall of boom to get into this game more than they are right now. They need to pick it up because this is their home court, and they need that presence.
Hayes High does average 2 points a quarter less in the second and third quarter of the ball game. So a very good team to start and a very good team to finish, but that middle ground is where they lose a little bit.
Yeah, I believe they only have 7 points so far in this quarter of play. That's
very atypical for
the Indians. Yeah, it's very low for them.
Clark getting caught off guard on defense, but Brady Worth with the block. And the crowd not liking that call as Brady Worth is called for the foul.
Crowd very, very upset. It did appear as though he may have clipped a little bit of ball before he had gotten his arm, but hey, call's a call, you can't change it. Student section getting into it now.
Meninga mad at himself for missing the first. Almost got teed up there due to his reaction after missing the shot.
Yeah, they fired the student section up now.
Wall of Boom comes alive. Meninga makes one. So now we have a tie ball game with only 45 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Nunnery with the ball. Now to Clark. Clark pushes it out to Riedel. Riedel back to Clark. Clark back to Nunnery. Back to Clark.
Look at when Hayes High swings the ball. Look how the whole Garden City team just shifts with it. They could swing it a little bit faster. They could get a look in the corner.
Garden City playing way outside with their zone defense. Watch out for Windholtz. He's camped out on the wing.
Pretty Great. Easy to lose track of a player that's just going to sit there, especially when they're running the clock down like this.
Time is ticking down. Now only 10 seconds left to play here in the third quarter as Nunnery brings the ball up. Now look inside. Kicks it out to Windholtz. Windholtz with the shot and won't knock it down. Now we have a foul on the floor.
It's going to be a push. Looks like it's going to be on number one.
2.9 seconds left to play here in the third quarter with Hayes High with a good opportunity on the rebound. Watch out for Brady Worth now.
Or Lane Clark. He's sitting over there in the corner if Nunnery sees him. Saw him a little bit too late.
Clayton Riedel gets the pass that came off the backboard, and that one will just get tipped around with no shot. So going into the fourth quarter, the score will be 33-all.
And we will be right back for the fourth quarter of action. Welcome back to Hayes High School.
As the fourth quarter starts, Hayes High and Garden City tied 33-all. Nurnberger with the ball. Now trying to get it inside to Worth, and that is a bad pass. Not something you normally see from Nurnberger.
Yeah, we haven't seen very many of those from him, if any, so far tonight. But, man, are we in for a ball game? It's a pretty much 8-minute ball game right now. Starting the final quarter of play, tied up. It's going to be a wild one.
Something that I don't think anybody thought was the starters from Hayes High have played an incredible amount of minutes, only dipping into two players on the bench so far. Garden City in the same boat, so both all starters for both teams getting pretty much the same amount of playing time.
And this is very low scoring for the Indians. They usually score much over this in a ball game.
Indians almost scored double this on average this season, at 60.1 points per game. They're only at 33 now here at the start of the fourth quarter. Hayes High does only normally give up about 40 points per game defensively as Tramp misses the layup there and gets the over the back.
Oh, man, that's not good for Tramp. That is not good. He's got to watch his fouls. He needs to be in for all seven of these minutes.
That shooting foul call at the end of the game has really gotten the Hayes High student section the wall of boom into this game as Nurnberger brings the ball up.
Tramp's got three fouls so far in this game. He's got to be careful. They need him all 7 minutes if they want to win this
Tramp
game. And there he is.
And Tramp with the
dunk.
Oh,
and he slams it down. He's coming at Hayes High in their house. He wants this ball game. He's watched them beat him twice. He's not going to let that happen if he can have his way in this game.
So now for the first time since the second quarter, Garden City has the lead. Lane Clark from three, and he knocks it down.
He is in this game now. Watch out. He's about to have a big quarter.
Lane Clark with his first bucket of the ball game, and it's a three. Hayes High with a one-point lead as the student section goes up. Now Hayes High trying to trap Koster. Tramp in. He misses the layup. Winholtz with the rebound.
Both teams have done what they needed right now. Tramp needed to get in the game and step up, and Clark needed to get back into this ball game. It's about to get wild.
Nurnberger with the ball, back out to Winholtz. Back to Nurnberger as Hayes High looks to set something up with 6 minutes left to play in the fourth quarter and a one-point lead. Tramp tries to jump another pass, but Nurnberger hangs on to this one. Out to Worth. Worth back to Nurnberger.
Man,
out to Winholtz on the wing. Winholtz for three, and that's short. Garden City with the rebound.
Inches away from Tramp taking it down and putting another dunk on him.
And the charge!
That was an iffy call. I don't know if Clark was set right there. I think he moved under him.
Hayes High will take it. Again, a one-point lead.
Yeah, Clark may have just gotten a gift right there.
That's Koster's second foul of the ball game. 15 foul here in the second half. Now Nurnberger will get the ball and take it up for the Indians.
Getting some great basketball right now. Brady Worth, oh, well, never mind. Brady Worth is on the floor. He's just sitting in the high post.
Winholtz thought about the three, now takes it out. He picked up his dribble now to Nurnberger. Nurnberger tries to get it inside to Worth, and Worth did not see that pass coming. Another costly turnover for the Indians.
Two turnovers so far for Nurnberger in this quarter. Needs to settle it down. He needs to make smarter passes because they can't have those turnovers right now.
As the student section comes alive for Hayes High. Naninga misses it. 5 second violation, Hayes High ball.
Man, that's, man, they got the ball back from a turnover, and then what do? They turn it over. They can't do that. Not right now. The student section getting into this game. They know what's on the line right now.
Nurnberger with the ball. Student section still in this one. Nurnberger now with the ball. He'll kick it to Parker. Parker looking for something. Now he'll dribble it out into Winholtz. Winholtz now goes up for the layup, and it falls.
Nice move. That was a great move right there by Winholtz.
3-point lead now for the Indians.
He can make plays. He can create shots. If you get him down low with one guy in front of him, he can get around him.
Naninga now with the ball for Garden City. Now to Tramp. Tramp back to Naninga. Now Naninga pushes it inside and a foul is called.
Ooh, and they're going to call it on the floor. Man, if they would have said that that wasn't the shot, that would have been an and-one opportunity, and he would have been shooting a free throw for a tie ball game.
Hayes High, that's only their second foul of the second half. Now Hayes High will call a timeout.
4:26 left, 3-point ball game. It just keeps getting better.
Hayes High takes a full timeout, so now both teams with three timeouts left with 4:26 left to play in the fourth quarter.
This place is alive right now. You can feel the energy.
Jim A. at Hayes High packed to absolute capacity here today. Just a great atmosphere for high school basketball.
The Indians trying to keep this perfect season going. Garden City trying to get their first win of the series. Again, the third meeting. You couldn't ask for a better ball game right now.
Hayes High looking for more offense here in the fourth quarter. Only a three-point lead and 4:26 left to play. Again, they're 22 points under their average 4 points per game. Now they've limited Garden City to about what they normally do on defense. Hayes High on defense, normally allowing about 40 points per game. And the student section is still alive here in the fourth quarter. Garden City now with the inbound. Hernandez inbounding it for Garden City. Out to Delgado. Delgado and Lenny.
They've got something going here off that inbound.
Delgado now with the ball. Back to Nodina.
Man. Garden City's just kind of standing around. They gotta move. Tramp can't. Wow, Tramp's getting pushed around by Parker right now. They don't even have Worth on him.
Nodina with the ball now. Now to Hernandez. Back to Nodina. Now to Delgado. Garden City just passing the ball around on the top of the key. Not really getting anything going so far.
No ball movement, or no off-ball movement for them right now. They need people to get open off
Nodina
the ball.
Nodina pushes it inside with a good look, but that'll be rebounded by Brady Worth.
Forced it a little bit. He wanted to pass out. You could see it when he first picked it up. He was looking for somebody to pass to. Saw there was nothing there, so he had to shoot.
Parker now with the ball, now to Winholtz. 3:20 left to play. Now to Clark. Clark trying to set something up for the Indians. Now to Nurnberger. Nurnberger to Parker. Parker with the corner three. And it goes in and out. Nodina now trying to bring up the ball. Parker with the pressure. Parker not giving an inch. Now Nodina will drive in. Brady Worth with the block. And Garden City will maintain possession.
Little confusion here on whose ball it is. Hayes High thinks it's theirs, but they're gonna say it's Garden City's.
Delgado now tramp with the easy bucket, and he misses. Man, that's Jordan Winholtz with the rebound.
That's at least the third basket Tramp's missed inside today that is you don't typically see from him. Good presence down low.
Nurnberger to Clark. Clark from the corner, and he misses. His dry spell continues, and now Jordan Winholtz over the back.
Winholtz needs to settle himself down a little bit. He got a little fired up after that, what he thought was their ball, a little inbound situation, and he needs to settle himself down here. He's got 2:43, and he needs to keep himself in this ball game.
Clark continues to struggle here in the fourth quarter. Again, another open three that he does not normally miss.
And there's going to be a full timeout by the Indians.
Now Hayes High only has two timeouts left. Garden City with three, with 2:43 left to play. Oh, again, a three-point game.
Yeah.
We will go to a quick break here, and we'll be back with live coverage of Garden City taking on Hayes High.
USD 489 Media, connecting the community to education.
And we are back with our live coverage of Hayes High taking on Garden City here in the fourth quarter. 2:43 left to play in a three-point ball game. Hayes High on top. Hayes High coming out of the timeout now. And the student section is alive here. Garden City will get the ball coming out of the Indians timeout.
Garden City ball, they're down by three, 2:43 left. This game, this is a close one.
Coster bringing up the ball for Garden City. He'll keep it now. Clark on defense. Coster picks up his dribble, now Lane pressuring him. Back
someone
to
needs,
Coster now.
Someone needs to get the ball from Coster. He doesn't seem like
there.
He wants it
Clark,
right now.
Clark got around that screen nicely. Tramp with the putback.
That was a good putback. He got his position, went up, and finished it. Well done.
Nurnberger getting it into Worth. Worth blocked by Tramp. Winholtz with the rebound.
What a block.
Clark with the fake. Now to Parker.
That was a great play. Worth had an easy bucket, and Tramp is playing amazing right now. For being the other, he's playing like he's at home. He's just playing with an edge.
There are not many players in the state that can block Brady Worth inside. Tramp is one of them. Great matchup inside today.
Yeah, in the whack, Tramp's probably the only one that's going to come up in there and make Brady work.
Hayes High fighting to continue their best start in school history. Nuremberger with the ball now. Nuremberger inside to Worth. Worth goes back, and Tramp fouls him.
Oh, that's a questionable call. I think he got the ball first. I don't know about that one.
Hayes High's best free throw shooter is at the line now.
That's Tramp's fourth foul. He has got to be careful.
Tramp in foul trouble now with 1:30 left.
That's
Worth
real,
at the line.
That's a real problem, because if somehow this game goes to overtime, he's got four fouls. He has to be careful, especially when he's guarding Brady Worth down low most of the time. He's got to be careful. No dumb fouls right now.
The atmosphere in this building is incredible right now. Worth at the line. He made the first, and now we'll miss the second one.
Two-point ball game. Garden City's got to get a good look here. They can't rush anything. They got to be smart.
Coster bringing up the ball for the Indians now. Dunninger with the ball. Now back to Coster. Clark on defense. As the student section comes alive once again, Tramp with the shot. That one will miss. Brady Worth almost with the ball now. Lane Clark with the rebound.
Tramp rushed it. He wanted the shot too bad, and it wasn't there.
Clark with the ball now. Now out to Nuremberger. Nuremberger driving now.
Oh, yeah, that was a push. That was a push. He dropped his shoulder, pushed his forearm out. Crowd doesn't like it, but that was a push.
Another costly turnover for the Indians. That's been the story in this ball game. Timeout taken by Garden City. It'll be a full timeout.
Can this game get any better? 2 points, 56 seconds, fourth quarter. Man, these are the games that you want to see. I mean, yeah, a blowout's fun. It's fun to see your team run away with it, but this is a good one. We'll be right back.
You spent yourself on a faraway love. It was bad for the heart, but good for the soul.
Takes on Garden City. A two-point ball game with 56 seconds to go.
Garden City's ball, they got the timeout. I would expect them to get a good look here. They didn't take the timeout for nothing. They definitely drew up a play. With a two-point ball game, I definitely don't expect threes. They're going to take it to the rim. If anything, they're just trying to get fouled. But, yeah, they got to get a bucket here.
Coster bringing it up for Garden City. Clark on the defense. Clark gets around the screen, great, and the student section is going mad. Brady Worth on the defense. Tramp with it, trying to put it back. Nuremberger with the rebound, and Nuremberger's fouled.
You know, we saw a team do this earlier this season. I can't remember who it was, but they started fouling Hayes High very early in the final minute, and they got close. I think the game ended in like a score like 5 points. So they must have seen that, because they've started fouling kind of abnormally early. Putting people to the line.
Hayes High in the bonus. Nuremberger at the line for his first 1-1, and he makes the first one. Clutch free throw there for Nuremberger.
3-point ball game.
Nuremberger doesn't go to the ball a lot, but about 56% on the season.
It's a big free throw right here.
And he makes the second one. Kyler Nuremberger with a pair of free throws. 43 seconds now left to play. Hayes High up by four. Nuninga on the sideline now. Clark on defense.
Yeah,
Nuninga pushes it in. Clark got a piece of it. And the foul is called on Clark.
Yeah, he reached. He reached in there. He got him.
Coach Keltner is not happy with that call. And he will take a timeout. 34 seconds to go. Hayes High now with only one timeout left, but a 4-point lead. And that'll be Hayes High's final full timeout. They will only have a 30-second timeout left to play with 34 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
Garden City could get a quick two, but I think they might want to look at possibly shooting a three right now. A two would be fine, but they're going to need missed free throws.
This is the tightest game Hayes High has played all season. Again, a WAC conference game. Hayes High fighting to remain undefeated on the season.
Yeah, definitely the tightest game they've played at home. They did have that overtime victory earlier this season. That one was definitely a little bit tighter, but this still is a great game. This comes down to who wants it more. How bad do they want to keep this run going?
Something to look at. Hayes High's defense has played up to par of what they do on the season. Hayes High's defense only allowing 40.8 points per game. They've only gave up 37 with 34 seconds left and have a score of 41.
Defense wins championships. I know this isn't a championship, but right here, offense isn't exactly what it normally is, but they're still keeping the numbers low, and it's low enough that they're still in the lead right now.
Hayes High is in the bonus now, so any foul committed by Garden City will send Hayes High to the line.
It's a big possession right here. They've got to get a bucket.
Coster with the ball out to Hernandez. Clark on the defense. Hernandez for three, and he will miss that one. Delgado with the rebound. Tramp with the shot. Tramp will miss that one. Brady Worth with the rebound.
Tramp rushed the shot. Second time he's done that in the final minute. He didn't even set. And I don't know if he was trying to shoot a runner or if that was his jump shot, but it didn't work out very well.
Now Garden City will send Hayes High's best free throw shooter to the line. Brady Worth, 64% on the season. He's at the line for a 1-1.
See if Worth can knock down his free throws here. These would be huge.
Misses the first, but they get the rebound. With the rebound.
Oh, Tramp steals it.
Tramp slams it home.
He throws down. Wow, this game right now. Tramp makes plays. Wow. That was an impressive play right there by Tramp. He got the steal. He didn't give up. He didn't go for the foul. Everybody on his team was like trying to run over and foul him. He just took the ball from Clark.
Now Garden City will take a 30-second timeout with only 18 seconds left to play in a two-point ball game here in the fourth quarter.
That was a great heads-up play.
Tramp is really the leading player on Garden City. But again, the starters for both teams have gotten a lot of minutes tonight. You have to wonder what effect that has here late in the fourth quarter. Lane Clark has been quiet all day, but Hayes High will definitely look to him still. Cade Parker going for the rebound. Brady Worth at about half court. Lane Clark, Kyler Nurnberger, and Jordan Winholtz about halfway in between them for the Indians.
Someone's got to make a play.
Parker looks
to Clark. Someone's got to make a play.
Now to Worth. Worth gets it. And that's the long reach of Worth. And Garden City will send Worth to the line.
Hey, I mean, yeah, it looks bad. But you might think that maybe there was something to that. Maybe they wanted Worth to get the ball. He just missed one. That could be in his head. He could be thinking right now, all right, I got to knock this one down. I can't miss again. That can mess with the player mentally. There might be a little strategy to this.
So now 9 fouls for Garden City. Worth at the line for a 1-1. Worth with the first misses
he
it.
Misses. All right, they got 14 seconds. They got a timeout. I mean, I
defense
don't see why they won't use
here.
It.
Tramp, Worth with the steal.
Whoa.
And Tramp throws him to the ground.
Whoa, they gotta calm down. He got a little too much into himself right there.
The student section, this entire gym is on their feet. Tramp with his fifth foul. Tramp is out of this ball game.
Yep. That is huge because he fouls out. They lose their sense of energy right now. And if Worth misses, even if he doesn't miss, say he makes one, and they get down and they tie this ball game up and it goes to overtime, they don't have their best scorer. Somebody else is going to have to score for Garden City and step up for that team.
Worth will be shooting three. Hayes High is in the double bonus now. So if Worth knocks both of these down, that makes it a two-possession ball game with 7 seconds left. Worth for the first one now.
And they
he knocks down the first one.
Yeah, they must have.
Did they tee up Tramp on that one?
Yeah, they must have because these aren't shooting foul free throws. That was a technical.
And he knocks down both. 4 points, 7 seconds to go. Hayes High's lead.
That's the ball game. He needs to control his composure.
Don't call it too early. 4 points is all that separates it with 7 seconds left. High student section definitely thinking they got this one.
Yeah, your wall of boom's calling it right now.
Hayes High does have the ball for the inbound. Clark gets the ball.
Garden City
with the late foul. Took him 2 seconds to foul Clark.
4 points, 5 seconds. It would be a miracle.
And Clark going to the line with double bonus. You have to think if Clark knocks down at least one of these, Hayes High has the easy victory. Again, number three in the 5A state, Hayes High leading by four. And Clark knocks down the first one.
Yeah, I don't know how much pressure he's feeling right now, but he shouldn't be feeling too much.
That just lifted all of it.
Yeah.
Chance to make it a 6-point ball game. And he misses the second one. Delgado now pushing it down the floor for Garden City. They need to get a shot off quick. Delgado with the shot, no good. Kyler Nurberg with the rebound, and Hayes High pulls out a close one at home.
Yeah, that was well played by Hayes High. It came down to composure of a single player, the best player on their team. He lost it, he fouled out. They had a chance there at the end. They didn't quite get it. Hayes High now 3-0 in the series with Garden City. They're 2-0 in the conference against Garden, and that was just a great ball game all around.
Hayes High improving to 17-0 and continues the best start in school history with a 44-39 victory over Garden City. This has been a 489 Media production. I'd like to thank you for joining us here at Hayes High School.